Hi, I know when I'm not feeling well or if I'm hurt, I go to a doctor. But who takes care of a painting or an artwork when it's hurt? Check out today's episode of Sketch with Jeff.
One, two.
It's Mr. Jeff. It's Mr. Jeff. And his show.
And pencil, too. It's Sketch with Jeff.
Oh, hi. Welcome to Sketch with Jeff. As always, I'm really excited to see you. I am fixing things in my studio. My helper Pencil wants to have an art exhibition, and I thought if I fix things up here, maybe she could hang her art up in my studio. It would be great. I love the sound of my hammer hitting those nails. And
Wait
a second. Did you hear that sound? That didn't sound good. Let's check in on Pencil, see what's going on. Pencil?
Jeff, I accidentally ripped my painting.
Oh no, Pencil, where is the rip?
Now it can't be in the exhibition.
Pencil, can you show me your point for a second? It's so sharp. I think that might be the problem.
What do I do?
I'm not sure, Pencil, but I promise we'll fix it.
I wish I could help Pencil with my tools, but the problem is fixing art requires special knowledge, skills, and tools. I can't do it, but I think I know someone who can. Let's go to the Guggenheim and find my friend Francesca, who is an expert at fixing art. Come on, let's go. Francesca? Is that you? It's me. It's me, Jeff.
Jeff, hi. Good to see you.
What are you doing?
Well, I'm a conservator at the museum. Hi, everybody. And part of the job of conservators here at the Guggenheim is we take care of the art.
Well, that is actually why I'm here. I'm so glad to see you. I have some art that I need you to take care of. Pencil
nice
made
painting.
A painting. It's a beautiful painting. Pencil made a self-portrait. I think Pencil had a little accident and put a hole right here where this cloud is.
Yeah, well, one of the first things that we do when we think about trying to fix an artwork is we have to figure out what it is. So, Jeff, I don't know if you noticed, but I'm wearing these gloves.
I did notice.
This is part of what conservators do to protect the surfaces of artwork. So we always wear gloves when we're working with art. And we also use special tools.
What's that?
This is an examination light that helps us really look at the surface. And one thing I noticed, this tear is in a part of the painting that has what we call impasto, which just means texture, extra kind of bumpiness. And one thing you can do is you can take a light, look straight on, but then take the light to the side and you see it looks like mountains. The damage isn't just in the paint. The damage is on the canvas.
All right, let me try this on. Ooh, that's a nice fit, I think. All right, and then what do I do? I pull
Lower
this down.
Them down okay. over your eyes.
Ooh, I see much differently now. I feel like things are out of focus, but, oh, wait a second.
Yeah.
Now I can really see up close.
Now we'll really get a sense of exactly what's going on with Pencil's painting. And I can make a plan to fix it.
Francesca said it would take about 2 weeks to fix Pencil's painting, so I thought, in the meantime, maybe we could make some art.
Francesca invited me to look at this painting using her special light, and I loved seeing the shadows made by the paint. And I thought, what if we were to make art using shadows? Let's do some experiments, see what we can do. So I'm starting with shaving cream. I know it's funny, but I'm spraying shaving cream on the paper, and as I move the light around, I really love the way the shadows change. The shaving cream reminds me of that thick impasto paint. Now I'm switching to blocks, more geometric shapes. How does that change the shadows? Well, the shadows are also a bit geometric. They make shapes on that bright paper underneath. This is really fun. Now some cardboard. I'm arranging cardboard shapes. This is kind of a combo of geometric shapes and curved organic shapes. And if I play with the shadows, it actually makes some pictures. So here's a way to make some art. I drew some lines on the paper, and then the shadows are filling in around it to make a really cool face. Takes a little experimenting.
You should try it. Have fun.
Hi, Jeff. How
Francesca,
are you?
I'm
good to see you.
Really
Hi,
good.
Everybody.
I'm also really excited. I think Pencil's excited too.
Well, I have something to give you and I hope you like it. I hope Pencil feels good about it, but it's the painting. We fixed it. It was a lot of work, but we got it done. And here you see this area that was repaired.
This is amazing. It looks like the painting was never torn, never ripped, never punctured. And I don't know how you did that.
Well, first we analyzed the paint to make sure we knew what we were dealing with. And then we had to repair the canvas underneath the paint. And then I had to add a little bit of paint on top to make it all look like you're painting again.
All of these special tools, all these special techniques, and Pencil painting is back to the way it was in the beginning. I'm so excited. I think Pencil's going to be too. You mind if we call her?
Show her? Not at all. I'd love to say hi to her.
Here she is. Pencil, are you there?
Wow, Francesca, I can't believe you fixed it.
Oh, Pencil, I really liked working on your painting. It's such a great painting, and I loved meeting you and Jeff.
I'm so happy.
Thank you, Francesca.
Jeff,
I can't thank you enough.
Really happy to help.
Pencil, thanks you too.
Come back to the museum.
We'll see everybody later. Bye. Well, I'm back here at the studio. I gave the painting to Pencil. Pencil, what do you think? Oh, there you are, Pencil. What's that?
My painting looks amazing, Francesca. You are my art superhero. Thank you.
Oh, you're really sweet, Pencil. And you're right. It's amazing. Your painting is fixed. Well, that's really good news. And now Pencil can have her art exhibition. I better get back to fixing these walls. At least I'm good at fixing something. Uh-oh. That's going to need another nail. I'll see you soon.
One, two.
It's Mr. Jeff. It's Mr. Jeff. It's Mr. Jeff. It's Mr. Jeff. And his show.
And Pencil, too. It's Sketch with Jeff.